Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to participate at DIA Care Conference 2021. And first of all, I would like to express my gratitude for your kind invitation. I would like to express my gratitude to my dear friend, Dr. Banshee Sabu, and to whole organizing committee. I will briefly speak about the next step in incretin therapy from single to dual agonism. When we talk about incretins, we have to emphasize that still the two main incretins are GLP-1 and GIP. And GLP-1 was discovered in 1983, and GIP was discovered even 10 years before that. These two incretin hormones are the most popular and most investigated, GIP and GLP-1. GIP, or gastric inhibitory polypeptide, and glucagon-like peptide 1, GLP-1, they both exert the effect binding to their specific receptor, GLP-1 receptor and GIP receptor at beta cell, and also on other cells as well. But when we talk about in beta cells, they work by activating the adenylate cyclase, and they will increase CMP level in pancreatic beta cells, and the final action is stimulation of beta cells and glucose dependent insulin secretion. We are all aware that incretin hormones play an important role in the human and normal insulin response. But also we know that the incretin effect is diminished in patients with type 2 diabetes. And it seems that satiety and weight loss is associated with GLP-1, but it can be synergized by GIP. GIP may also improve bone strength, cognitive function, some aspects of lipid profile, but also GLP-1 receptor agonist, it seems that inhibits bone resorption indirectly. So they both incretins, GIP and GLP-1, they have different effects on different organs, but some of them are very similar. On the other hand, we know that GLP-1 receptor agonists and GIP as itself, they can increase insulin secretion in pancreas. GLP-1 can reduce glucagon levels and the secretion of glucagon, but GIP will increase glucagon secretion. They have similar effect on beta cell apoptosis and proliferation, but also similar effect on memory. Unfortunately, it seems that GIP have no beneficial effect or effect at all on food intake or satiety. On the other hand, we know that GLP-1 have beneficial effect on cardio protection and also nephroprotection as well. After the results of LIDA trial published 2016, we learned that the cardiovascular mortality was reduced by more than 20% in comparison to placebo. On the other side, all-cause mortality was reduced by 15% in comparison to placebo, and also liraglutide showed the beneficial effect on renal protection and significantly decreased time to first renal event. On the other hand, another long-acting GLP-1 receptor agonist, semaglutide, showed the beneficial effect on cardiovascular outcomes and especially on primary composite outcome, especially all-cause death, non-fatal myocardial infarction, and non-fatal stroke. In Rewind trial, dulaglutide also showed the beneficial effect on cardiovascular composite outcome, first occurrence of myocardial infarction, stroke and death, and hazard ratio was 0.88. On the other hand, that was particularly seen in a rate of stroke. Harmony trial showed that albiglutide, which is not available on the market, also showed beneficial effect in significantly reducing primary outcome cardiovascular cardiovascular, and it was for non-inferiority and superiority, albiglutide showed significantly decreased the risk of primary outcome events, myocardial infarction, stroke, and also cardiovascular death, and particularly in the part of reduction of myocardial infarction. We can explain that maybe not just throughout pancreatic cells and throughout the good glycemic control, because you know that many landmark trials confirmed that beneficial effect of long-term good glycemic control couldn't exert effects like this. And we know that beyond glucose metabolism, it's not about just the effect of incretins on pancreatic alpha and beta cells, but or their proliferation or inhibition of apoptosis, but also there is plenty of other effects on different organs which can influence on glycemic control. On the other side, there is GLP-1 receptor agonists are widely distributed in human body, what can have impact on cardiovascular risk reduction and also renal protection. You can see it here, the explanations, but I will not go into all these details, otherwise this presentation will go long for several hours. But what about GIP analogs? GIP analogs as anti-hyperglycemic drug, it was discussed for more than 10 years. 2009, Irving and Flett discussed about therapeutic potential for GIP receptor agonist and antagonist. Well, 10 years gap for GIP analogs or antagonists as anti-hyperglycemic drugs, we can ask ourselves why. So probably the main reason was that attention was diverted away from GIP because of by the successful development of GLP-1 receptor agonists. On the other side, GIP was found to have little effect on glucagon secretion or adipose deposition in obese type 2 diabetic patients. The effect of GLP-1 and GIP on glucose metabolism is similar, but you can see it here that both of them can decrease the glucagon, can increase beta cell mass, can increase insulin secretion, but GIP doesn't inhibit glucagon. And GLP-1 decrease glucagon secretion and hepatic gluconeogenesis to inhibit glucagon. And this is the main difference between GLP-1 and GIP. Also in type 2 diabetic patients, there is reduced response to GIP. And on the other side, in type 2 diabetic patients, there is a reduced release of GLP-1. GIP for type 2 diabetes effects and challenges. We know that there is reduced insulinotropic effect of GIP is considered as important pathophysiological component of type 2 diabetes. This reduced ability may be due to glucose-induced downregulation of GIP receptor. So strict glycemic control may partially restore beta cell sensitivity and glucose homeostasis. So if we have hyperglycemia, in that case, we will have downregulation of GIP receptors. On the other hand, glucagonotropic action of GIP in type 2 diabetes is preserved during periods of hypoglycemia and euglycemia. And Based on short-term clinical experiments, using GIP as a single independent anti-diabetic agent seems poor, but in combination, GLP-1 receptor agonist and GIP receptor agonist could have beneficial effect on glucose control, but also weight loss and maybe many other beneficial effects, other as pleiotropic effects. So in vitro and animal models, it seems that combination agonism and antagonism of GIP receptors activity can have beneficial effect on weight loss. So maybe dual agonism, GLP-1 and GIP should work, because GLP-1 receptor agonist reduce hyperglycemia. Reduced hyperglycemia or mild hyperglycemia can increase the activity of GIP receptor activity. And that can restore the action of GIP and action of GIP receptor. We spoke about cardiovascular effect of GLP-1 receptors, receptor agonists. But what about the cardiovascular effect of GIP? Well, as I already mentioned, there are plenty different receptors of GLP-1 and also GIP all over the human body. And the heart express both incretin receptors, but the cardiac biology of GIP receptor action remains to be explored. It seems that the GIP receptor agonism is associated with reduced progression of atherosclerotic lesions in some of preclinical trials. So from that perspective, it seems that the cardiovascular effect of dual agonism, GIP and GLP-1, remains to be explored in the future. Cardiovascular effects of GIP in vitro, there are many different explanations, trials, but it seems that what we can emphasize that there is increase in nitric oxides, but no consistency across cell types for change in inflammation. So maybe inflammation in some cells, but not all of them, and also increase in nitric oxide concentration. Cardiovascular effects of GIP in animal models can be divided in the field of atherosclerosis, because activation of GIP receptor can decrease plaque formation. On the other side, can have beneficial effect on restenosis, maybe cardiac remodeling, and also inflammation, but with diverging results, as I already mentioned. In humans, there are also several trials in normal glucose tolerance or healthy young people, impaired glucose tolerance and type 2 diabetes, and the results were, results were that GIP receptor agonism can decrease mean arterial blood pressure and also can increase heart rate. In summary, regarding cardiovascular effects of GIP, we can say that the GIP can be promising as anti-atherogenic, but also as pro-atherogenic properties in vitro. In vivo, it seems that GIP receptor agonism could have beneficial effect or protection against atherosclerosis in non-diabetic patients, but also in diabetic conditions in vivo. Furthermore, it seems that multiple beneficial effects of GIP are observed in other diseases like osteoporosis and Alzheimer. Tirzepatide is a novel GIP and GLP-1 dual receptor agonist, produced by Eli Lilly company, and its affinity is comparable to natural GIP and for GLP-1 receptor, and also for GLP-1 receptor. It stimulates CAP accumulation and also have beneficial effect on glucose control, but not just on glucose control, but also in weight loss and better results in food intake with increased energy expenditure in mice with diet-induced obesity. On the other side, there are many clinical trials. I will not go in through it. It's, some of them are placebo control, like Surpass 1 trial, and I will briefly comment on it. And also head-to-head trial with insulin, first and second generation of basal insulin, but also with GLP-1 receptor agonists, long-acting agonists. And Surpass 1 clinical trial is comparison with placebo. Tirzepatide is administered subcutaneously once weekly because its half-life is 5 days, and it has very similar adverse event like GLP-1 receptor agonist. And after 40 weeks, reduction was up to 2%. Weight reduction was approximately 6.3 to 8.8 kilos. The results in achieving of glycemic control were also impressive, because 92% of subjects had HbA1c below 7% versus 19 in placebo, and 50% of subjects who were included in a trial achieved HbA1c below 5.7. So we can say that it was reversal from diabetes to normal glucose homeostasis. On the other hand, atherogenetic lipoprotein profile also improvement, and the results of dual GIP and GLP-1 receptor agonism showed improvement in atherogenic lipoprotein profile, especially ApoB and LDL cholesterol level after 26 weeks. Very recently, it was published one study which showed that it seems that the dual agonism, GLP-1 GLP receptor agonism, and also GIP receptor agonism, could improve the beta cell function and insulin sensitivity. Also, could decrease insulin resistance, and glucose control and weight loss could also be achieved even better than only GLP-1 receptor agonist as a monotherapy. In summary, we can say that GIP and GLP-1 are still the two main incretin hormones. GLP-1 receptor agonist is well-established therapeutic option for type 2 diabetes, with proven weight loss, cardiovascular protection, and also renal protection. GIP's role in glycemic control, weight loss, and cardiovascular system is still not very clear, but dual agonism, GLP-1 and GIP, dual receptor agonists called tirzepatide, have shown glycemic and weight loss benefits. It seems that would suggest that GIP, not alone, but in combination with GLP-1, might have beneficial and potential therapeutical effect. And we are waiting for Surpass CVOT, which will show the results of dual agonism, GLP-1 receptor and GIP receptor agonism, and we will expand our knowledge in cardiovascular domain of dual inhibition, dual agonists. But it seems that all those soldiers looks very similar, like they are all the same. But it seems that we know that they are not the same. We know that they are unique. And it seems that even dual agonism of GLP-1 and GIP receptors could have beneficial effect not just on glucose control, weight loss, suppressing satiety, suppressing appetite and increasing satiety, but also could have beneficial effect on cardiac protection, maybe even nephroprotection. So we have to wait for the future results of CVOT trial in this field, but it seems that a dual agonism of GLP-1 and GIP looks promising. But for the end, we have to consider one very important thing, that beside all those pharmacotherapy and therapeutic options, majority of people with diabetes still are not achieving good glycemic control, because education is, at the end of the day, the most important thing for people with diabetes. Like George always said, helping others is good, but teaching them to help themselves, it's even better. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that future is promising for treatment of type 2 diabetes. But on the other side, we have to work on education as well, because educating people with diabetes, how to treat their disease, how to discover and how to prevent their disease, how to discover disease in earlier stage, and how to prevent complication is the most important thing. And we are lucky to have so many therapeutic options. And I'm quite sure that dual agonism of GLP-1 and GIP receptors will be promising for the future and for all of us who are physicians treating people with diabetes. Thank you very much.